Lord. Anoint me. Let me anoint Jesus. Anoint me. Let me anoint yours. Let me in the other room.
Thanks for joining us this beautiful Sunday morning. The doors of our church remain closed, but our hearts are wide open. John 3:3 says, except a man be born again, he cannot see the kingdom of God. John 3:5 says, except a man be born of water and of the Spirit, he cannot enter into the kingdom of God. Having said that, we are going to go into a message being entitled, I Know Him for Myself. But first, a special testimony by Deacon Tony and Sister Gloria Hill.
Now, years ago, just to say, I had a liver transplant, and I had complications during that surgery, and death came up before me. But yet, God delivered me from that. 2 days later, after the surgery, after he delivered me from that, they said I had cancer. God delivered me again. Keep your faith in him. Don't be wavered about the things that's going around us. He said in his word, he'll never leave us nor forsake us. Keep your faith and remember through it all that God is always there.
It's been 17 years now that I have been on dialysis, and they all were good years. I never had complaints until last year. Last year, trouble came my way. I had a hernia surgery, and during that hernia surgery, I ran into problems, and I had to go back into the doctor's office for them to check me out, and when I got there, they said, we have to transfer you. When they transferred me, I didn't know what happened from there. When I woke up, I was on the respirator. I died 3 times, and the Lord was so good to me.
Yes.
He didn't allow me to stay dead, and I'm seeking his eternal love, because he's been better to me than I've been to myself. Yes. You know, and through it all, I feel like a trooper, because God said, not yet. You went running to heaven with a high five, and the Lord sent you right back because you got many things to do.
We are a living testimony. We could have been dead and gone, but Lord, you let us live on. You know that we are a living testimony, and I thank the Lord I'm still alive.
I am a living testimony, and I thank the Lord. I thank the Lord.
Go with me if you will to Acts 4:11 and John 14:6. And the Bible reads on this wise. This is the stone which was set at naught of you builders, which has become the head of the corner. Neither is there salvation in any other, for there is none other name under heaven given among men whereby we must be saved. We move over to John 14:6. Jesus said unto him, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto the Father but by me.
I want to leave this with you. I know him for myself. I know him for myself.
And the word was made flesh and dwelt among us, and we beheld his glory, the glory of the only begotten of the Father full of grace and full of truth. Do you know him? Believe in the Lord Jesus Christ and you shall be saved. Deny him and you will be lost. Do you know him? I know him for myself. He is the only way. He is the only Savior. He is the only healer. He is the only Redeemer. He is the only Deliverer. Nobody else can save you. Nobody else can heal you. Nobody else can redeem you. Nobody else can deliver you. He is the only true God. Neither is there salvation in any other. I know him for myself. Do you know him? Do you know him? Demons tremble at that name, at the sound of that name. Every knee must bow at the sound of that name. Every tongue must confess. One Lord, one faith, one baptism, one God and Father of all, who is above all and through all and in you all.
I was raised by my mom and dad, but my dad died when I was 7 years old. The church my mom attended was Jerusalem Baptist Church, not too far from where we lived. Jerusalem remained our family church for a number of years. The first time I remember going to church, I was around 5 years old. It was a Sunday night service. In my own little way of thinking, at 5 years old, the church was packed, the choir was singing. The preacher started preaching and I fell asleep on my mother's lap. When I woke up, I heard these words: "May the Lord watch between me and thee while we are absent one from another." When my mother talked about God, she would always say, "You're going to need the Lord one day. You had better honor, respect, and obey your mother, that God won't shorten your days."
Therefore, be it known unto you that through this man, Jesus Christ, is preached the forgiveness of sins. God gave his only Son, and Jesus Christ is the only one offering eternal life. There is no one else offering eternal life but Jesus Christ. Jesus said, "I came that they might have life and that they might have it more abundantly. And this is life eternal, that they might know thee, the only true God, the only wise God, the only Savior, the only begotten of the Father, and Jesus Christ, whom thou hast sent." "I am the first and I am the last. Besides me there is no God. Therefore, if any man be in Christ, he is a new creature. All things are passed away. I am not come to call the righteous." Jesus said, "I am not come to call the righteous, but sinners unto repentance." Jesus Christ, the only way. "I am not come to destroy the law. I am not come to destroy the prophets, but I am come to fulfill." I am the only way. We belong to Jesus. We belong to God. We believe in receiving the baptism of the Holy Ghost. We believe that Jesus is the only way. For there is but one God and one mediator between man and God, the man, Jesus Christ. "He that believeth on him has everlasting life." Jesus said, "I am the way. I am the way. I am the way." If you do not believe that I am the way, you shall die in your sins. "He that believeth on Jesus is not condemned, but he that believeth not is condemned already, because he has not
believed in his name.
If you do not believe that I am the way, you shall die in your sins. He that believeth on Jesus is not condemned, but he that believeth not is condemned already, because he has not believed in the name of the only begotten Son of God. And he that believeth not the Son shall not see life,
but the wrath of God abideth on him. This same Jesus, he's able to save to the uttermost. This same Jesus, his name shall endure forever. This same Jesus,
his name shall continue as long as the S-U-N. The same Jesus, he is King of Kings. He is Lord of Lords. He is Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end, first and the last. He is that living bread. He is the door. He is the root and the offspring of David, the bright and morning star. Seek him while he may be found. Search for him while he is near.
Ask and it shall be given. Seek and you shall find. Knock and the doors shall be opened.
By the time I was 12, my mother had begun to study with the Jehovah's Witnesses. We had Bible studies in our home on Wednesday nights and walked 5 miles to Bible study at Brother Shaw's house on Friday night. I really loved Sunday mornings because we had to witness from house to house with our circuit overseer. And even at age 12, I was the designated driver to move the cars as others walked from house to house in the neighborhood. I really enjoyed that. By the time my mother passed away, I had been preaching a number of years. At the end of her life, my mother lived with my wife and I, but only for a few days. She had a stroke and went to the hospital. I spoke with the doctors, and the doctors said to me that everything will be all right, and that my mother would recover. 3 days later, she was gone. I remember calling the hospital to check on her that Sunday morning, March 20th, 1983. When I spoke with the nurse said, "Sir, there's nobody in Mrs. Butler's room." She paused. And then she said, "Sir, Mrs. Butler died this morning." At that moment, I thanked God for knowing Jesus. I thanked God for receiving the Holy Ghost. I thanked God that I know him for myself. Let's go back into the service.
When you come before God's altar, just say, "Lord, I want to be saved." When you come before God's altar, just say, "Lord, I want to be forgiven." When you come, say, "Lord, I want to live for Jesus.
I want to be set free." When you come, just say, "Lord, I give myself away so you can use me." Believe and accept Jesus. He will save you. Jesus, the Christ, the Son of the living God. He said, "He that cometh unto me, I shall in no way cast him out." Let us pray.
Lord God, our Heavenly Father, in the name of Jesus, God, we come before you, recognizing you as the only way recognizing that no one else can save us. No one else can take us over on the other side, over in the promised land. Bless your people everywhere, from the greatest to the least. Remember the sick and shut in. Remember the homeless, those that are in prisons, those that are in the hospital. Remember, oh God, those that have been affected by coronavirus. Please, God, in the mighty name of Jesus, stop this virus in its track. Send it back to the pit from whence it came. Then, God, give us brotherly love. Put us back on the right track. Heal the land. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. Amen.
It is important to know God for yourself, because at the name of Jesus, every knee should bow of things in heaven and things in earth and things under the earth. And every tongue shall confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father. Not having a personal relationship with God can cause you to go down the round road, to follow the round crowd, to make dangerous and bad decisions in your life, even decisions that might cost you your life. The most important things that you should do to know God for yourself is to love the Lord thy God with all your heart, with all your mind, and with all your soul. To know God is to love him. To love God is to love your brother. To know God is to not just flatter him with your lips while your heart is far from him. To know God is to keep his commandments, because he said, if you love me, you will keep my commandments. I think heaven will be all right. Oh, sister, just as long as you're there, as long as there is you. Everybody. Things that eyes have not seen, nor ear heard, neither have entered into the heart of man. I want to see the things which God has prepared for them that love him and that have kept his commandments. I want to be in that number when the saints go marching.